Hi everyone, Dr. J here, and in this video I'm going to talk briefly about a couple of concepts in the book which might be a little bit confusing when you're first getting into this, related to resistivity. So you can see here we've got our very basic resistivity setup, the ground surface where we're standing, and we've got just four electrodes, and as you have hopefully by now seen from the book, this is basically the minimum number of electrodes that you would need to do a resistivity survey. And just to put some context, we have a source and a sink node. So electricity is traveling through the ground from the source to the sink. And we're measuring the voltage drop or voltage potential difference across the two point nodes. Now, one of the things that might be a little bit confusing is the fact that we have both different types of arrays as well as different types of surveys. So I wanted to talk just a little bit about the different array types and the different survey types. So the winner spacing is kind of an even spacing, and your source and your sink electrodes are on the outside. For the Schlumberger spacing, you have these two electrodes in the center, and your sink and source electrodes might be farther out. And for the dipole-dipole setup, you have source and sink on one side and your potential measurements on the other. Now, when it comes to the types of surveys, we're really interested in two basic types, either one-dimensional or two-dimensional. Vertical electronic sounding or vertical electric sounding, CST, is essentially a horizontal sounding technique. Vertical is obviously VES, vertical electric sounding is obviously a vertical sounding technique. And these techniques can be carried out using really either type of array, although certain array types are more suited to one or the other. So for example, the Wenner array type can be used for CST. And you essentially, you put your four electrodes out, you take a measurement, which essentially represents one measurement at this point. So given this particular four electrode configuration, a single measurement, this would give you a single measurement of apparent resistivity at a depth of approximately half the P1, P2 spacing, and at a position that's exactly in the middle of this array. Now you can do this again by simply moving your source array to the other end. You can again switch around your source and sink and 0.1, 0.2 electrodes and get a second point over here, and so on and so forth. You can continue to do this in two dimensions, and you can plot out a resistivity curve. So for example, this might be of interest if you're looking for the location of a fault. And so if we were to do this type of a survey, this is again essentially a 1D survey, 1D in space, a single constant depth related to our electrode spacing, and we're just moving our electrodes along. Now again, if we were to cross this fault with these measurements, and there were two different resistivities, we would get a curve, and I don't know exactly what the curve would look like, and it depends on what the resistivity values are, but that curve would essentially show us where the fault is located, and we could invert that curve for the fault location and all those kinds of things. So this is a 1D horizontal profile. How about a vertical profile? For example, vertical electric profiling. So in that case, we might have our, for example, in the Schlumberger array, we would have our four electrodes again in our same configuration. There would be some closely spaced center point electrodes, and then a source and sink electrode that's a little bit further spaced apart. And what we would do is we would simply move those outer electrodes further out. And eventually, at some point, if our signal gets too small, we might have to move these ones out as well. But what are we doing? As we move our electrodes out, so for a particular depth, let's say right here, our electric current might look something like this. So CST, we're sampling at a constant depth, but in space. VES, vertical electronic sounding, we're sampling at a single point, but in depth. Now, electrical resistivity tomography is a different method entirely because it's actually two-dimensional. And it becomes two-dimensional by stacking up a whole bunch of one-dimensional measurements. So as you've probably read by this time in the book, ERT works by taking a set of electrodes. It's going to take that set of electrodes and make one measurement there. Then it's going to take the next set of four electrodes and get another measurement here, and so on and so forth. Then it's going to be able to actually use more electrodes. So it might take those six electrodes, it'll have the outer two be source and sink, and the inner two be our point measurements, and it's going to get a measurement right there. And you'll notice in this case it can only get two measurements because we don't have enough electrodes. And then it might use all of the electrodes and get, you know, measurements down there. This is why a pseudo section has this triangular shape. It's because it's sampling deeper depths, and as you go deeper, you have fewer electrodes. So if you wanted to sample out further, you could again extend this over, but then you'd also extend your shallower measurements over, and so it would still look like a triangle. The point is that this is now a two-dimensional sampling, or sampling of two-dimensional space, underneath this electrode array. And it's doing it using all these one-dimensional samples, but it's building up this 2D sample by taking all these measurements. So for survey types, we have both two-dimensional and one-dimensional methods. And then which type of array that you use is going to depend on what's going to be best for your survey. So for an ERT survey, we use the Werner spacing because it makes sense to do that, right? We need electrodes spaced every so often in order to use this 2D imaging methodology. If we were interested in vertical electric sounding, VES, we would probably use a Schlumberger array, because in that case, we only have to move two electrodes at a time, or at most four electrodes. We don't have to set out all of these electrodes to get just the vertical electric profile. Or if we were only interested in 2D structure, like crossing a fault, we might use the CST method. But in general, the ERT method is going to provide fully two-dimensional results, so it's going to be superior to the other methods because it's giving you both space and depth dimension variability. All right, so with that, I will wrap up and see you in the next video.